Hey everyone, Ronnie here at Cleaves Tech, and in this video I'm going to go over a new feature that was recently added to Focus in the latest update 2.4.3. Some people have asked me about, and most of you may not even have noticed, and that is the ability to use the Playground 2.5 model in Focus. Now, this is not one that you go and download off of Civit AI and drop it in. It wouldn't have worked before now, but it's been changed around so you can now use it in Focus, but you do not need to download it. You do not go and download it or anything like that. All you're gonna do is in Focus here, when you're on the main interface, you just gotta go ahead on the presets up here, click on it, and go down to Playground 2.5. And when you do that, everything will be switched over that needs to be switched over, because it's not as simple as just a regular model where you would drop it in. So this had to be changed to accommodate that. But once you've gone over to that preset, then you'll be all set. Do remember, the one thing you don't wanna do is you don't wanna be on your regular preset here. Let's say you're on the initial preset. You don't just go into the models and then change it in here, because it will be listed in here. But what will happen is when if you go to try to use it, you're not gonna get results that you'd be expecting. And that's pretty much what you're gonna get if you do that. So if you get these sorts of results out of Playground, then that's what you've done wrong and you don't wanna do that. You just wanna go into the presets and change it, because that configures everything, because there's more to it than just the models and things like that. You actually would have to go in, if you go in your advanced developer debug mode, then you'd also have to change the scheduler, because it is using its own scheduler in here. That's one of the other primary changes. So do keep that in mind. Now, the other thing that happens when you choose that preset, it's gonna change your guidance scale default to 2. Now, I do find a little under 2 or even 3 sometimes works well with Playground depending on the image, but 2 is actually a very good baseline to start with. So I would say start with 2 whenever you're generating anything, and then you can play around with it as you see fit. Now, the styles, it only enables the Focus V2 style by default. It doesn't enable a lot of the photographic ones, because you'll find that this model doesn't do as well with photographic stuff. And the other thing you'll notice is it changes over the performance to speed. Now, I did a lot of testing and I found probably 40 steps might be better than the 30 that speed has. So if you wanna go in, you can go into the advanced section under the developer debug, and down under forced overwrite of sampling step, you could change this to 40 and now overwrite whatever you have set up top. That's up to you. I honestly didn't find a huge difference between them. So the one on the left was with the speed setting and the one on the right was with the quality setting. Now on this one, I felt that the one on the right definitely was better. So 60 was definitely better than 30, but I found usually 40 was just as good as 60. So I really don't think there's any need to go to 60. I did do these just to give some examples of the differences between the two. So from 30 to 60, you definitely see better eyes, but usually by about 40 steps, you'd see all that anyways. Similar here, 30 on the left, 60 on the right. Similar quality. I think the right one on the right is a little bit higher quality, a little better. Now, the thing to keep in mind with this model is I would describe it as more of an artistic type model, more, in my opinion, more towards Midjourney results. I think you'll get out of this. Now, I'm not going to get into all the technical details on it. It isn't SDXL itself. It's not based upon that, but it's the same. I believe it's the same architecture. So they did not change the underlying architecture. That way everything would still work with minor changes. But there is some things that won't work, and I'm gonna get into that in a moment. Now, some of the things that they worked on was enhanced color and contrast. And that's one thing I definitely could say that is vastly different. Although their comparisons, they're comparing it with standard SDXL. And I'm gonna show you some comparisons to give you an idea after, but I did see an improvement there. Now, some of the other things is multi-aspect ratio generation. I don't know if it was any better than SDXL, a lot of the models that I used. They claim that it is, and it may be better than the standard SDXL. And then the human preference alignment when it comes to eye shapes, facial detail, things like that. In all honesty, I don't think it does as well when it comes to people. than some of the other newer models that are out there. Definitely probably than the base model. But when it comes to the other ones, you're not going to be going with your standard. If you're using this for your models, photorealistic stuff, you're probably not going to be using this model. I do like some of the results. As I said, you do not need to go download it, so don't bother going to Civit AI to download it. When you first use it, when you change this preset over, it does need to download everything in the background. So it does take some time before on your first use for that to download. There is a few limitations that you won't be able to do with this. The first thing is LoRAs. Now, I haven't extensively tested it with LoRAs. I'm not sure how it works with those because I don't get the results I expect from the LoRAs, but I do get something. I'm gonna use this one. We got the same seed set, and we have our balloons LoRA, which makes things out of balloons. And I got a cat made out of balloons here. Yeah, let's go ahead and see the results we get from that. So not exactly what I'd be expecting. But then again, those LoRAs are not trained on playgrounds, so it makes sense that they're not gonna get the results I would expect from them. But they do have an impact. They are actually doing something, because if I disable these, I will not get this sort of results. Just to show you what I should get, so this is on a standard model here, and I'll go ahead and generate to give you an idea of what they normally would look like. So I think you get the idea. This is what normally I would get from that LoRA on, you know, using it on a standard one. And using it on here, I'm going to get vastly different results, which makes sense because these are not trained on that model. But I did find it interesting when I ran a lot of these, I got a lot of different results than what I expected from them. And some of them actually came out very, very interesting. So I do plan on playing around with some of these. Okay, and just to show another LoRA, just to give an example of the differences. As I said, I found each LoRA getting different results from. Some are similar and some are not. Like the balloon one definitely wasn't very similar, but it was still interesting. But let's try the lava one. So I'm going to do a flower made of lava. Way we don't have any burning cats. And let's go ahead and generate. And I'll also do the same thing under Juggernaut. Our lava, flower made of lava. Now, not exactly what I would have expected from this model, because if we go over to the Juggernaut version, we do definitely get a much different one that looks like more like lava, whereas these are not. But if we go ahead and disable this and generate under the same seed, yep, we should definitely get some different results. Just, I'll show you that right now just to show that the LoRA does have an impact. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, these are actually pretty interesting as well. But as you can see, definitely different results than what we just had while we had the LoRA enabled. So just pointing out that depending on what you're using, don't expect the results that you'd normally get from your LoRAs. So they'll probably be useless overall. I haven't found myself trying to really use any overall with the playground model myself. So now the other thing that you want to keep in mind as well that doesn't work with the playground, as far as I can tell, unless something hasn't been enabled yet, but my understanding, I just don't think it's going to work, is any of the image prompts. So like for here, if we have the Pirate Canyon and I do a dirt track race car and I have everything set, when we hit generate, we should see that start immediately influencing the image generation, the lines and everything. But as we're going to see here, we're not going to get anything close to that. That is having zero influence on that image. Image prompt section, none of those will work. I haven't tested out face swap, but I tested everything else out, so I don't see why that would work. Now, for the other limitation or thing that you might need to change is when it comes to in painting. If we were to go ahead and generate this, this is the default in painting. Okay, so as we can see here with the in painting, this is the result you're gonna get. So that's not gonna work. Now, I did find there is a way to use in painting I haven't fully tested it because I haven't done a lot of inpainting with it. If you go into the advanced under the developer debug mode, what you need to do is in the inpaint image section under the inpaint tab, that drop down, go in here, change that to none. And now it should work. You may not get as good a results as you normally would get with the built-in inpainting from Focus than that you normally get with the regular models, but I did find you're gonna get much better results than if you try to. It's useless otherwise. Okay, so as we can see, better results, but not great. I mean, but much, much better than you would get otherwise. So that's how the inpainting I found. You can use inpainting with this. Like I said, I haven't done a lot with it, so I can't really tell you 100% how well it works overall. The one thing I also did find is upscaling seems to be hit or miss. Now, I'll just show you an idea of what happens when you go to upscale normally, and then we'll compare it to another technique that I'll show you in a second. So on these, I'm just going to go and upscale it 2 times, and I'm just going to leave it as base settings for the moment. Okay, well, this proved me wrong. These didn't come out too bad, but I did find when I did a lot of the upscaling before, I got a lot of weird results. So instead of upscaling it with the playground model, you could switch to a different model at this point. So let's go ahead and I'll show you, just give you an idea. We're gonna uncheck those, and well, we could go with Juggernaut, but I'm gonna go with the Zavi Chroma. I've been playing around with that a lot lately, and we'll just upscale it with that model instead of the playground model. Okay, so just to show an example, and this kind of proved me wrong, but because these, it did upscale without any issues, but I will mention that if you run into any issues, you can upscale with something else. So this was upscaled with Zavi Chroma on the right and playground, depending on the look you're going for it. But what I had happen a lot of times was I ended up with a lot of distorted ones. It was like every other one was messed up. So if you do run into that, you can upscale with a different model if you're having problems upscaling. So do keep that in mind. So that's basically how you use it, some of the limitations of it. What I'll do is I'm gonna actually now pull up some of the images that I've gone ahead and ran through on a few different ones just to get an idea of some of the differences between this and the traditional models. I went with the Playground 40 steps just because I found that seemed to give the best results. And then for the Juggernaut and Zavi Chroma, I used the 60 steps quality. I turned off everything on these, the Focus, V2, and all that sort of stuff. Now, one of the things that I will say is when it comes to the blacks, it does a very good job when it comes to dark blacks and colors. That's one thing that they highlighted, and I will agree that that's one thing I think it did very well. Then we have our frog on a solid black background, same idea. But I will say Juggernaut did pretty much better than I expected here, and the Zavi Chroma as well. Then we have our Viking ship. Although I'm not an expert on Viking ships, but I don't think Playground got the Viking ship correct. So I guess it doesn't know what that is, but I'm not an expert on Viking ships. So then we have our black UFO in front of Rising Sun at Dawn, and it definitely shows the differences in the colors that it can accomplish. Then we have our black hammer in front of a white background. All of these actually did pretty good. Then we have our town square lit only by torchlight. Here it definitely shows the blacks and how well Playground does when it comes to the blacks compared to the other ones. These are more washed out. And as far as Peter Pan, age 60 years old, black background, these all did good with the black background. Definitely different styles we're going to get from these. And that's one thing you're going to notice with Playground. You will get definitely much different styles than what you're used to. Here as well, the colors are much more vibrant, I feel, with the Playground. And that's one thing I did notice with a lot of the Playground ones. The artistic stuff definitely does come out pretty well. This one, our young skeleton and smiling little girl. Interesting thing on these is certain models on my skeletons. Juggernaut doesn't understand what a young skeleton is, but Zavi Chroma and Playground did. as I was mentioning, the two on the right here, Juggernaut and Zavichroma, look more like photos, whereas the one on, you know, Playground has got that more artistic feel to it. Then we have our human-like octopus sitting in a recliner with a human fish tank side table. Well, I think the Playground one got the prompt more correct on this one. The prompt adherence was much better on this one. Watercolor painting, I think these all did pretty well, but I do like the style of the Playground one. These are the types of things where I find the Playground does much better at. That pretty much covers everything I had to talk about when it comes to the new Playground model and focus. I have yet to really dive into using it besides testing, but I do look forward to seeing what it can produce. If you found this video helpful, please do consider hitting the like button. And I also do have a Patreon set up if you want to help support the channel. I do want to thank those that have. And I also do expect to have some stable Diffusion 3 content in the near future. And no, Focus does not support Stable Diffusion 3 yet. The results have been mixed. We'll see. Thanks for watching and have fun creating.